Cities are basically systems of systems, and those systems can operate optimally or not optimally. And a key component is how we move around in that. We should be able to provide equitable mobility. Give you a ride from any place, no matter what your economic background is, what you look like, where you come from, all of that can be programmed into a vehicle.
So what you're seeing right now in the screen on the far left is the regional highway system. It is moving fairly slowly right now. Where we often see congestion in the city of Boston are those places where people are trying to get onto regional roads, the highway system.
I have the honor of serving as Mayor Walsh's Chief of Streets, and we're focused on those 9 square miles of Boston that are our streets. As we think about the future of the city and those things that will potentially most fundamentally change transportation, autonomous vehicles is at the top of that list.
There's a heaven or hell scenario that we talk a little bit about, the autonomy heaven or hell scenario. The hell scenario is that we have individual internal combustion autonomous vehicles. And eventually we'll have an autonomous traffic jam full of gas-emitting, fossil fuel-burning, single-occupant vehicles that are autonomous. The heaven scenario is the opposite. Optimist Ride is based in Boston, and the reason why we based it there is that it has all the unique roads, all the unique drivers, and all the unique weather of Massachusetts, which allows us to test and, you know, really prove the technology itself.
Optimist Ride wants to provide a shared electric and autonomous mobility. We want to make sure that folks aren't being left behind. People tend to have difficulty connecting to transportation options after a 10-minute walking distance.
So what if you had a self-driving system that connected you from where you are to the subway, for example, a fixed infrastructure like that? You can have a fleet of vehicles that can dynamically contract and expand based on the real demand.
Autonomous vehicles can potentially work better as part of a network and consequently increase the reliability of travel on our streets. That is why the city of Boston is really actively engaged in the testing of autonomous vehicles.
So you're currently an Optimist City. Optimist City is about 9,000 square feet of space, which allows us to have our own private test track. In Massachusetts, you can't actually do driverless on the public road, so this gives us an opportunity to do as much driverless testing as we need to fully vet it and get it ready for the real world.
So we're in the Optimist Ride now. The vehicle is programmed to drive autonomously throughout the entire seaport of Boston. We have John and Alfredo, our two test operators. They're actually not driving at all. They're monitoring the vehicle as we're starting to drive. And we've been able to map the entire environment around us. We're also planning and looking at the trajectory of all the other objects as well. And over time, with more and more data, we're able to then improve the entire network at a very, very high level.
One of the things that we are learning through the process of having testing on City of Boston streets is if there are design modifications that we need to be making to city streets to have them work for autonomous vehicles. One of those things would be a digital atlas of the curb rules in the city. Potentially a digital layer that a vehicle would have so it knows where in the City of Boston it can be able to go.
My view is that you can deploy this technology in an existing city today, and over time that city will evolve. I also believe that you can design a city today with autonomous vehicles in mind, and you would design it very differently than a city that was pre-automobile or even post-automobile. It has the power to do both. Everyone needs transportation, everyone needs mobility. There's a deep correlation between your mobility and your wealth level too. So if you're a wealthy person, you can afford your own car, you can afford your own private jet, but if you don't have that, then you're probably taking a bus for 4 hours, right? And that level of inequity and the impact that has on not only the people's lives, but also the way you design cities, that's a future that we have to kind of shape.